First item on the agenda is leaders' questions, and I call on Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Alaska and Corda Taoiseach. This week, the Executive has usurped the Parliament and has forced upon us a debate on government priorities for the next 3 days, with no legislation at all being tabled by the government side. And in that context, I would like if you could confirm for me, Taoiseach, whether the government has actually delayed making any decision on implementing Minister James Riley's plans for universal health insurance for a year until a major costing exercise is complete. A draft memo that was circulated by the Minister for Health to his cabinet colleagues found its way into the Irish Times this morning and has put in a lot of caveats in relation to the timetabling and the plan itself. And I would put it to Taoiseach that it might be a good exercise in the public interest to publish that draft memo so that we could all see it and we could all have a reasonable date this week when we're discussing the government's priorities to discuss its major priority, i.e. The introduction of universal health system allegedly in about 6 years' time. And it would be no harm if we could have the opportunity to discuss that meaningfully this week, given we are meant to be discussing government priorities. And people really would like to know the potential cost to them as individuals and as families of such a new system, because the Dutch model has increased overall per capita costs by about 46% since its introduction in 2005. And I think we need a very honest debate with people. Somebody somewhere has to pay for health services. Somebody will have to pay for the future health service, irrespective of the funding model that actually is adopted. And I would put to you, Taoiseach, would you accept that there will be a significant increase in costs to the Exchequer in the years to come following the introduction of the universal health insurance system? And also, there will be a significant cost to individuals and to families. The 2 million people who already have health insurance will face extra costs in relation to the actual basket of services that they currently enjoy under the health insurance policies that they have. And likewise, there's less than 1 million people, about 1 million people out there, Taoiseach, who neither have a medical card or health insurance. So I think you need to be honest and say to that 1 million, you will be paying a tax from now on in terms of the new model. Thank I think you. We need to be very straight with people in that regard. And so what I want to ask you, Taoiseach, is it the case that you have deferred making a decision in relation to Minister Riley's plans until a full costing exercise is complete? Two, will you accept that there will be an increase in overall health expenditure to the Exchequer as a result of the introduction of this? And we know that Minister Noonan and Mr Howland have articulated their concerns about that. And thirdly, that there will actually be an increase to the costs of many individuals who currently have health insurance. There will be actually will be an increase. I think Minister Howland, has said it could be up to 1,600 per person per year.
No, I don't accept that at all. First of all, the government have not put off a decision on UHI. The government have not put off a decision on UHI until next year. I do not accept the premise of your remarks about an increase in costs for each individual. I do accept that this is the most radical and fundamental change in the health structure since the foundation of the state. We can't obviously continue with a system which is inequitable, which is unfair, which penalises those on lower incomes, and which is costing an extraordinary amount of money. In your own time, it was costing 16 billion. So the decision of the government today was actually to confirm the concept and the principle of universal health insurance. But clearly there's a need for a process of consultation with people so that everybody understands what is involved here. And I think the fundamental difference, Deputy Martin, between what's there at the moment and what will apply under universal health insurance is that the package of services to be available to people and the choice for each person who makes a choice as to which is most suitable for them will include access to primary care and to GP care, so the current cost that's being paid there will not be a cost under UHI. It is a matter of very considerable importance that there be no confusion about this, so that the process of consultation will involve people from around the country, ordinary citizens, men and women, families and no families, who will be impacted by this, but also a central role for the Oireachtas Committee on Health, an understanding that of being able to explain the value of having a single-tier system where there is equal access as distinct from a two-tier system which is discriminatory, unfair, exceptionally costly and is not working. So I think what you're trying to get at here is, can you tell me today what the average cost per package would be? And I can't do that because obviously UHI is not going to be implemented in full for some time. So the process is already in train. You have the strengthening of the primary care services, that's already part of this. You have the you've got the special delivery unit, the establishment of six hospital groups, the patient safety agency, the first phase of value from money follows the patient. These are all parts of the process leading to the implementation of universal health insurance. So the answer to your question is, government have accepted and confirmed UHI, its concept and its principle. Government will continue to discuss the question of how best to roll it out so that there's a process of being able to explain to people exactly what's involved here. And I don't accept your figures or your assertion this is going to cost more, because the Minister for Health has already said that the universal health insurance cannot cost more than the ineffective two-tier system that's there, and that the implementation of the programme will be subject to the constraints of the ceilings set by the Minister for Finance and the Minister for Expenditure and Reform.
Thank you, Deputy. Supplementary question.
You've confirmed the original question. You are delaying it, and you just said that you've confirmed the concept. But you've confirmed the concept since before the last election. Money follows the patient, all that kind of soundbite stuff that got you over the last election. You've now teed it up to get yourself over the next election with no detail. Certainly you get by the local elections with absolutely no detail. And if anybody is sowing confusion, it is you and Minister Riley. So the next plan now is to get to the next general election, and you'll tee it up again, and you'll make the exact same promise you made 5 years ago, which will then be 5 years. You'll say, actually, we have another 5 years to go but before we'll implement this, with no detail whatsoever. And the point I would make to Taoiseach is that I think you need to be honest with people, Taoiseach, and say, this will cost more, Taoiseach. And it will cost people extra money. Now, I didn't say that, by the way. I wasn't the first to say that. Minister Noonan and Minister Howland were the first to raise the red flag on this. Were the first to. And I look, if you're nodding your head, publish the memo that was circulated today. Publish the memo. Why not publish the memo? If the Irish Times can get it, surely the Dáil can get the memo. And why not publish the white paper? I mean, we have been waiting, the people have been waiting 3 years for the white paper on universal health insurance. And the bottom line is this, despite all the talk of radical change, the only reality for people on the ground is that health insurance policies have gone up 60% in the meantime. That's the only reality on the ground for people. And tax relief for health insurance policies has been curtailed. And there's huge uncertainty around the private health insurance market. That's what's happening right now. And the same is happening with medical cards. Medical cards are being taken from people. 35,000 medical cards are being taken from older people this year. Disgracefully, young children with multiple special needs have had their medical cards taken from them.
Thank you, Deputy.
No, sorry. That's why people are worried out there.
Please.
Because their sense of universal health care as advanced by this government has meant a withdrawal of services from them, both in the primary care field and indeed in the acute hospital setting, in the community care setting in the form of home health hours being reduced, and in terms of private health insurance, in terms of a massive increase in premia and a reduction actually in the tax relief available. So there's an incredible yawning gap between the reality on the ground as experienced by people and the rhetoric that's been peddled day in and day out with no detail and no serious or substantive debate in this House about what is meant to be the government's number one priority. It's not even been tabled this week for debate.
Taoiseach. Sorry, please. Please.
You've had your little rant there.
I don't reply to this question.
Let's go, I don't accept your assertion at all that this is an attempt to put universal health insurance and it being explained to people out beyond the next general election. As I've said to you on many occasions, that's in the spring of 2016. Long before then, Deputy Martin, people will understand and know that the universal health insurance concept and principle and proposal will be explained to people. Will be explained to people, so that everybody understands the value of having a single-tier system as against a two-tier system. Of course, you would say, why wouldn't you, that costs would increase? After all, in your own time, it went up by over 320%. From 3 point. It's a long time ago. From 3.6 billion.
Sorry. Yeah,
from 3.6 billion to over 15 billion. Okay, and we ended up, as I said recently, with nearly a world record of 569 people on trolleys on one day in January 2011. That's the legacy that you left behind you, and that's a system that you appear to be wanting to defend and continue and perpetuate. So it's very necessary with the rise in population, the longevity of people now, the changes in medical systems, that we move to a single tier system of health. This works. This works, Deputy Martin, in most other countries in Europe. And what will apply here will be a system that is very suitable for our needs here in Ireland. Now, you mentioned about about private health insurance. Obviously, Minister Riley has set out on many occasions that the McLaughlin report, for instance, pointed out way after way of being able to reduce costs by private health insurers. As you know, VHI increased theirs by 2%, others went up by 13 or 15%. The issue for government here, this is going to impact on everybody in the country. So we want to get it absolutely right, Deputy Martin, in being able. Hold on, Deputy Healy-Ray, in being able to be central to this radical change in the way health is delivered, and that's why the Oireachtas Health Committee will have a central part in dealing with the preparation and the analysis of the of the baskets of services to be provided for people, so that if you get away from the position that everybody will understand that what's involved here is equity of treatment and access to treatment, and that it's on the basis of medical need as distinct from what you can pay, and the question of community rating being subsidised by those on lower levels for higher levels is a pretty serious piece of restructuring of the health services, and we've got to get it right. I accept that, and I don't want a situation where everybody is floundering around in confusion about what it doesn't mean and about costs that have been assessed. Yes, Deputy Dooley, we had members of your party before talking about exorbitant charges for this, that, and the other. So yes, we'll publish it very soon, Deputy Martin. Very soon.
Thank you, Bishop.
Very soon. Very soon. Very soon. Personally, in the next couple of weeks.
Thank you.
Yes, I did. But it's. Yes, but I didn't tell you. I didn't tell you 320% of an increase.
Sorry,
and
please.
I don't accept your figures. This is about getting it right, because it's going to apply to every person in the country.
Thank
and
you,
everybody will have their say on it, and you can defend what you want now is an inequitable system that's grossly overcost and that's not working in the
Deputy Gerry Adams. Deputy. Can we have order, please, though? No. Sorry, Deputy Dooley, we can't have this. Deputy, can we have order, please?